like you tonight to consider the biblical difference between being a believer in Jesus Christ, being a follower of Jesus Christ, or being a disciple of Jesus Christ. From the time that I was 5 years old to the time that I was 13, I was a believer in Jesus Christ. I was raised in a pastor's home, an incredible home. Until I got to Bible college, I thought every Christian home was like ours. Oh, was I ever wrong? I had the most incredible upbringing of anybody that I've ever known. I had a mom and dad that gave their entire lives to the gospel of Jesus Christ, that loved each other desperately, and a dad that let every single one of his kids know on an individual basis, and our mom, that we were desperately loved. And I had no problem at all thinking incredible thoughts about the possibility and the reality that God could be my father. And I thought if he's better than my dad, he's got to be absolutely amazing. Most kids can't say that. In fact, it's God being their father is a pretty uphill climb. But I didn't become a follower until I was 13. If you'd have known me before I was 13, let me just say I'm glad you didn't. I was an awful kid. I mean awful. When I was about 11 years old, I come from a family of six. When I was about 11 years old, 11, 12 years old, my parents took me into their bedroom. They sat me down in a chair, and my father said this to me. He said, "Young man, we've tried everything we can to raise you in the ways of the Lord. We've disciplined you in every way that we can think of. And it's just not working. So your mother and I have gotten together and covenanted in prayer, and we've turned you over to the Lord for his discipline." That was a pretty rough year. I came to the Lord Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior on January 25th, 1970, about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Believe me, I know the time of the day. Probably every single one of my family does as well. Made a big shift. And all that Bible that I knew and all those scriptures that I've memorized and all that stuff that we had to do, I call it snow on the mountain. When Jesus was up in Caesarea Philippi, very, very close to Mount Hermon. Some of you might know the Sea of Galilee is fed from the melting snows from Mount Hermon. So if there's a lot of snow on the mountain, it's going to be a good year. Man, I had a lot of snow on my mountain. But when I gave my life to Christ, and he saved me and he changed me, all that snow melted, and it's continued to flow like rivers of living water in my life from then on. I started teaching and preaching when I was 14. And except for a space of about 3 months, a number of years ago, I think I've taught and preached crap every single Sunday of my life since I was 14. I love God's Word. I love the Lord. I think Jesus asks again and again and again, and he's asked it many, many times in my life. And it's really, really important. Who do you say that I am? not in general terms. You know what? If you'd asked me that before I was a believer, I'd have given you the right answer because I knew it. If anyone wants to save his life, he'll lose it. But if anyone loses his life for my sake, he'll save it. Because what advantage is it if an individual would gain the entire world and lose his own soul?
Who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing, love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, ransom from heaven.
summer light, the sky. You held creation as it came to life. You amaze me. Oh Lord, you amaze me. I watched the ocean crash against the sand. Behind the boundaries of your unseen hand, you amaze me.
Say that I am.